Hello everybody, I'm decided to play with the Technic Pack installed in the game. This is a brand new world I've just spawned in. Now, a couple of things. I'm not going to be spawning any items. I do have too many items installed as part of the Technic Pack, but what I find it useful for is searching recipes, because there's so many of them. So you can type down here what you're looking for, and then if you press R and hover over one of the too many items, sorry, if you hit return down there to deactivate that, press R, it will show you the recipes for making items. So that's what I'm going to use that for, that's why it's on. I'm not spawning any items with it, and I don't intend to. Okay, so other things. I've changed more creatures a little bit. So with vanilla mobs, I've turned on the creeper frequency. You still see creepers, but not so many of them. And I don't want them blowing up my creations as part of the Technic Pack. This really complex stuff you build, and I don't want it destroyed. And for similar reasons, I've turned off more creatures, hostile mobs. I've set them to hard. I'm playing on medium difficulty. So that's the ogres, don't want them coming through breaking anything. And I've turned off wraiths, werewolves, all that kind of stuff, apart from some of the easier mobs. Just giving a bit more life to the world, but really some of them are just annoying, so I've switched them off. Okay, so when you come into Technic Pack world, the first place, or the first thing to do, is decide on a base location as normal, and that's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to do it off camera. The kind of things I'm looking for is perhaps a millionaire village close by, definitely not in a snowy biome. I'm going to want to upgrade my electric power to solar panels pretty soon. A desert location, as I'm looking at there, might be okay, but there's a lot of mobs like scorpions and spiders that you get in there. So I want a large oil well that I can use as part of buildcraft. So those are the things I'm going to be looking for. I'm going to start searching now. It's a random seed. Let me go back in. Here's the random seed. It looks like there's an MP or a... there's some building over there I can see on the mini-map in that direction. Anyway, that's where I've spawned. It's a random seed, and now I'm gonna just go and explore and see what I can find. Hello everybody. So I've had a skate around, and what we have over here, I just about survived the first night hiding in a hole. I hadn't gathered any resources. I was just doing the scouting thing. But there's an oil well. I'm not sure if you can see it over there. There it is. There's an oil well there, here, here. Close to water. I'll probably start a quarry in this area. But some of the things I've found, there is a thing. So these are waypoints. You can set them up by pressing the comma key, and I'm going to set one up for oil so I know where this is, and that puts a marker on the map. And if you have a look at the minimap at the top, I think this is Ray's minimap. That's what the addon is part of the Technic Pack for this. Now, there's my oil marker, and you can see at the top of the minimap there's two other markers. One is a thing I found in a desert. It looks like a dungeon. I'll explore it at some point. And there's a village, the green marker over there. Now, if I press X, it'll tell me how close I am to a village and whether it's active or not, and I think it's active. It seems to be sort of under 300 meters. Oh, let me show you some things with the wood. So as part of this Technic Pack, There is... I don't really want to mess with him. Don't go away. I don't have any weapons. And I'm running low on food. Okay, so the Technic Pack. Just put that down. Make ourselves an axe. One more wood. So it kind of auto harvests trees for you. A bit more realistic, so gravity has effect on these. One type of tree it won't affect is this one. This is a rubber tree. It's part of one of the packs. Now, some other things you should be aware of. You really don't want to be smelting down too many items at the start. Reason for that is you are going to have the ability to turn all ores and double them once we've set up some buildcraft stuff. Now, that means the only things I've smelled so far is 3 iron to make this iron pickaxe, because that's needed to mine this stuff. Okay, so what gem is that? Sapphire. I've also just been exploring the world. I ran out of food, so I had to kill some crocodiles, and they drop leather similar to cows. And so that's sapphire I've just mined up. That I can turn into tools similar to diamond tools. And I found an abandoned village. It was a Norman village, and I found some food, so that was very handy. That's what I was really searching the surface for. Okay, this is emerald. Similar to sapphire. There's no apparent difference between any of them. And this stuff, I can't quite remember what it is. Let's have a look. Right, this is apatite, and I believe it is used for farming, and we'll come on to that in a future video. I don't think I need to use the iron for it, so I'll use it my stone picks first. Okay, this here is tin, and it's quite a major resource. Stone pickaxe will get it. Quite a major resource in this mod. Oh, creeper. So I did say, although I switched off creeper spawn rate, so I turned it down, you still get the little blighters. Okay, this is uranium, and it's used in nuclear power. It's not something I'll be using for a long time, but if you see it, gather it. I'm not sure whether I showed you this one. This is copper. It's similar in abundance to tin, but a slightly different level. Copper appears all the way down that iron does, and tin I think is around level 40 and below. Copper is extremely important in industrial craft. Okay, here's another resource. It's called nickelite. I have no idea what it's used for yet. I don't think it's part of industrial craft, but I'll have to investigate. This is down around the diamond level, so there's lava pools just over here and that. Main thing you want to do on this first mining expedition to get yourself set up is you need a lot of redstone, copper, tin, iron. Once you've got those, you've got the basics of a setup for industrial craft, and that's what I'll be coming back to once I've mined out a little bit more down here. Okay, here's another block type. It's marble. It's used for decorative purposes. Well, that was a relatively successful mining trip. I've managed to pick up all this stuff. No diamonds, unfortunately, but there's a lot here to get going with. Now, there's some extra little bit of resource gathering we need to do before we can make the industrial craft stuff, and that's really what I have been working towards. So all that mining was getting set up for the industrial craft. I might have mentioned build craft earlier on. Build craft will be a little bit later on when I'm starting to work with the oil wells outside. But so what I've just made there is a tree tap. Oh, the Norman hoe I found in a village, on the abandoned village in a chest. Same place I found all the bread. Okay, so you know, this location for my mine, that goes all the way down to where you saw me at earlier on. Now, I am looking for a rubber tree that I can tap. Now, there's one there. You can see the three leaves sat directly on top. There's a couple there. Now, we need to get... this creates insulated wire, and we need quite a lot of this to get going. So I'm just clearing out the leaves around it. So you can see that orange thing there is where we're going to... That's where we use the tree tap. Get what we need. I think you have to leave the three leaves on top, but the rest of the leaves you can clear away, and gives you a little bit more space to work. And you can see all around the tree then. Okay, so where was that? There it is. Take my tap. And just right click on that. It's given me one sticky resin.